On the edit page, there are a couple ways to split a video clip. The first of which is using command backslash. And the key here is really the location of the playhead. So as you see where the playhead is located, if we go ahead and hit command backslash, that is going to be where we make the cut. Now the other method is to switch to the blade edit mode, and we can do that by simply hitting the B key on the keyboard. And once we're in the blade edit mode, the cursor is going to become the blade itself. And once we're in this mode, we can literally make the cut anywhere in the timeline. We don't have to worry about the position of the playhead. And the best thing about this method is that we also get a time code that tells us where the blade is, so we can be more confident about where we make the cut. Now, one thing you will notice is that all these cuts that we have made, they have this dotted line that are running through them. These are called through edits. And what that means is that all these cuts that we made, the clips next to them, they are part of a continuous sequence from the original source clip. So what that means is that we can actually revert these cuts by simply selecting these cuts and then hit the delete key. Now you'll see that the cut is now being removed. We can actually revert all these cuts and bring back the entire video clip. Or we can select the cuts and right click, and in the menu select delete through edits. This will also remove all these cuts. And so this is one of the things that make splitting video clips on the edit page unique. On the cut page, since we don't have the blade edit mode, the position of the playhead is pretty much going to determine where the cut is going to be made. Now, if we're in the locked playhead mode, then in the lower timeline, the playhead is always going to be locked in the center of the screen. Now, if we move to a free playhead, now this is going to work very similarly to the edit page, where the playhead is moving freely, and we may have to occasionally move the playhead to where we want the cut to be made. So to split a video clip on the cut page, the first method is to use command backslash, very much like what we did on the edit page. Where the playhead is positioned, if we go ahead and hit command backslash, that's going to be where we make the cut. The second method is to right click the playhead and in the menu select the scissor logo. That is going to allow us to make the cut at the position where the playhead is located. And this is something that's very special to the cut page. Now the last method also involves the scissor logo, but it's going to be the one that's located on the top left corner of the timeline. By hitting that scissor logo, we effectively have made the cut at the position of the playhead. And out of all these three methods, you will notice that unlike the edit page, it doesn't show us through edits. It doesn't show us where through edits are. But the good news is that we can still revert through edits very easily by simply selecting the cut, by selecting through edit, and then hit the delete key. That's going to allow us to revert all these cuts and bring the video back to its entirety. Now, one last thing is that you may ask, what if I accidentally hit a cut that's not a through edit? Well, then you will notice that an error message is going to come up that reminds you that you cannot revert this cut. So this is one big difference between edit page and cut page when it comes to splitting a video clip. I hope this helps, guys, and I will see you next time.